Hey guys, happy Friday to all of you. Before we head for the weekend, I wanted to do this quick Facebook Live, so I didn't want to forget. So I was talking to someone earlier this week. That guy is into sales for the last 14-15 years, and he's trying to do some kind of career change, or he's trying to explore his options. And he's been watching me in terms of what I've been doing with digital marketing, web, social media, so on and so forth. So he wanted to kind of bounce off a couple of ideas with me, and a couple of takeaways came out of that. So I wanted to kind of share that with you. So thanks, Mukul, for joining. And so basically, the first and foremost, right, the first foremost takeaway was all of us, whether we are into 9-to-5 profession, business owner, or a startup, all of us are selling something. Either we are selling ourselves, or we are trying to sell our services, right? So for example, if you're doing like a 9-to-5 job, you want to make sure that you position yourself correctly in front of the recruiters, headhunters, so on and so forth. If you're a business owner, you want to make sure that your products and services are bought by your target audience, your buyers, right? Or if you're running a startup, you want to make sure that investors give you good amount of money, and then you manage stakeholder expectations, right? So that was the first and foremost takeaway, that irrespective of whatever profession we are in, we are trying to sell something, right? Now, the second takeaway was that to me, selling and marketing, they represent two sides of the same coin, and the coin being your buyer, your customer, your target audience. So selling is essentially something happens after the fact, and then marketing is, to me, really happens before the fact. And what I mean by that is selling is something that you do with someone when you're on phone with someone, right? And then marketing is something that you do to get that person on the phone with you. So there is a subtle difference between selling and marketing. No doubt both of them are very important, very crucial. But if you want to be a good salesman, I sincerely believe that you need to be a good marketer. And what I mean by that, right, you need to position yourself, whether you are doing a 9-to-5 job, whether you are a startup CEO, or whether you are running a business, right? You need to position yourself as the go-to person for your own respective target audience, target market. And that allows you to position yourself in such a way that your buyers, your target audience become already pre-qualified, pre-motivated, and they know that you are the only game in the town. And that only happens because you are educating them. So that was the next takeaway. And what I mean by that is, I really don't think you should be convincing your target market, your buyers, your customers. Your job as a salesman is to provide value. Your job as a business owner, as a marketer, is to provide value so that your buyers then can convince themselves. And the idea here is that, what I mean by that is, there is a term in the marketing, is that you need to enter into the conversation that is going on into your customer's mind. And the way to do that is you need to kind of be acutely aware of what are their pain points, challenges, frustrations, likes, dislikes, and then you need to come up with content in that fashion that kind of speaks to all these elements, all these attributes. A couple of days back, I did a Facebook Live where I talked about social media is a cocktail party. And the basic premise behind that was, you don't do business in a cocktail party. The idea is that there is what is called know, like, and trust model. So you need to get to be known first through your website, through your blogs, vlogs, articles, so that your target market knows that you exist. The second part is the liking aspect, where people get to like you, right, as a human being. Because even on the social media, right, even though it's a virtual medium, we are actually interacting with a live human being. So people get to first know you, then they need to like you, and then the third part is the trust part, which is where you need to become a problem solver. And the way to do that is something that I was just talking about. You need to kind of get into your customer's mind, sort of understand their pain point, challenges, frustrations, and then you need to come up with the content. So the next takeaway was basically when you are doing a business with anyone, right, whether it's a real life or social media, right, the number one thing that people keep on thinking about is whether can I trust this person, right? And I think that is where this know, like, trust model is of immense value. And the way to do that, right, is basically, I'm going to give you a couple of examples, right? So irrespective of whatever profession you might be in, right? So let's say if you are a financial planner, right? So you can come up with some kind of creative content that could be videos, blogs, articles, whatever you can think about, right? So think about this, right? So for example, if I'm a prospect, if I'm trying to hire a financial planner, right? So what are some of the things that might be floating into my mind, right? So as a financial planner, you can come up with some creative content. So for example, one content could be 8 questions to ask to your financial planner before you make any kind of decision. That could be one, right? Or maybe 7 costly mistakes that people do when it comes to financial planning. So what is happening here is that you as a business owner, you as a creative marketer, right? Because on the back you are acting, you are using all these marketing principles, best practices. So as a savvy business owner, you are trying to put yourself into your customer's mind and you are providing them all the input, all the data, so that they can then make a decision. And then the more you start talking about their language, the more they start relating to you. So that was the final takeaway. So I'm closing this basically. So that was really a fascinating discussion because he was in the sales, I was in the marketing, and we hit it off very quickly on that. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you got some value out of that. So thanks, Abhijit. Thanks, Rashmi. Thanks, Supriya. Thanks, Mukul. I'll talk to you soon. Have a great weekend. Have a great day. Bye-bye.